Hello, and welcome to your socially distanced June edition of Signal Boost. I'm your host, Callie Pruitt, Senior Strategist for Grassroots Advocacy in the APS Office of Government Affairs. And here's your science policy update. This month, the APS Office of Government Affairs has been hard at work advocating for the protection of optional practical training, or OPT. The White House had threatened to issue an executive order that would suspend OPT. For those who may not be aware, OPT is a vital program that allows students to partake in temporary employment to receive practical work training to complement their education and is instrumental in our nation's ability to attract and retain the best and brightest students from around the world. Earlier in the month, OGA took action to mobilize APS members around a Dear Colleague letter focused at Republican House members. Advocates urged their Republican legislators to sign on to Ohio Representative Steve Stiver's letter in support of protecting OPT in the U.S. Through this campaign, nearly 550 letters were sent to Congress by APS members, and as a result, 12 members of the House who had been contacted by our advocates signed on to the letter that was then delivered to the administration. After the letter's deadline closed, OGA continued to mobilize around this issue, switching our focus on the Senate. APS members were encouraged to write letters to their senators, urging them to join with their House colleagues and to do their part by reaching out to the administration to communicate the importance of OPT. Through this campaign, more than 3,000 members wrote to their senators, leading to almost 6,000 letters to Congress. This is an absolutely astounding show of support from the APS community and one of our most successful campaigns ever. The efforts of APS members played a key role in the administration's decision to ultimately not include OPT in the list of suspended programs in the recently announced executive order. However, the executive order does freeze other important visa programs, and OGA is continuing to address the challenges it creates for our physics community. Nevertheless, we should all be proud to have helped limit the ramifications of this order. In addition to this outpouring of support, APS member Mike Mayo published an op-ed in the Austin Business Journal that asks the Texas congressional delegation to do its part by supporting OPT and urging the Trump administration to do the same. You can take a look at the op-ed at the link in the description. Our team would like to thank Mike and all our APS members who raised their voices on this issue, and we will continue to keep you updated on the progress of this advocacy. In other news, last month, APS OGA released a new informational video on the importance of high-skilled immigration. The video talks through two key steps toward ensuring the U.S. continues to attract and retain the best and brightest students from around the world in under 2 minutes. First, by making the F-1 visa dual intent, then providing a clear path to a green card for international students who earn advanced STEM degrees from U.S. institutions and secure job offers from U.S. companies. I hope you'll take a look. You can find the full video at the link in the description, as well as take action to let your legislators know about this critical issue. Finally, APS is excited to announce the launch of our new advocacy platform, Phone to Action. The switch was made to provide a more user-friendly way to promote change in science policy. Plus, the ease of use and mobile friendliness of Phone to Action helps expand our impact on Congress and grow our base of members who are actively participating in advocacy. I hope you'll take a look at our new Action Center at the link in the description. That's all for this edition of Signal Boost. Have a healthy and safe month, and I'll see you next time.